Virginia, what happened to these five kings?
I know where it's at. Verse 21.
And all the people returned to the camp to Joshua and Makkedah in peace. None moved his tongue against any of the children of Israel.
Et tout le peuple revint tranquillement au camp de Josué à Makkedah, et sans que personne remît sa langue contre les enfants d'Israël.
You see, now they're winning. Everybody started respecting the children of Israel. This is exactly what is going to happen if you put the stone in the entrance of the cave. God will give you respect. God will dress you with that respect. You are a son of the king. You are a daughter of the king. You don't belong to this world. We were created and chosen We are chosen before the beginning of the creation of the world. And God's willing, we return into the kingdom. But first, you have to conquer your own kingdom. You see, the kingdom of God. It's like if you see those churches. Every church is a part of the kingdom of God.
Chaque church est une partie dans le royaume de Dieu.
You see how many people are here? Okay, these are the people of God that are working for the kingdom. But we need everybody. Because if you do your work, that part that represents the chair in the kingdom of God is
going
to be complete. How do you know it's complete? Because it lights. Like a Christmas tree. You see? It must have light. If you have your light inside, turn off. You're not the light of the world. When you kill the enemy inside you, it's like God turns on the light. We need every single chair here. The ministry and the church to be full of light so the kingdom will be complete. This is the reason why Jesus don't come yet. The kingdom is not complete. Jesus don't come from 1 million churches. Jesus come for one church. Jesus doesn't come for the people. Listen to me, Jesus is not coming for the people. Jesus is coming only for the ones that are waiting his coming.
Yes.
Read the Bible.
Leave it back.
Jesus is not coming for the people. Jesus is not even coming for a church. Jesus is coming for the people that wait his coming back. You're not gonna find that the Bible says that Jesus is coming for the church. Jesus is coming for the people that's waiting for him to come. There is something that is a characteristic of the people that's waiting for Jesus. You see the face of the people? You see light. You see light. Hallelujah. You see light. Praise God. Verse 22, then said Joshua, open the mouth of the cave and bring out those five kings unto
come out of the cave.
Josué dit alors, ouvrez l'entrée de la caverne et faites en sortir ces cinq rois et amenez-les à moi.
Verse 23. This is very important. I want you to concentrate. Because here you're going to have a revelation. Verse 23 says, and they did so and brought forth those five kings unto him out of the cave. The king of Jerusalem.
Yes. Il fit ainsi et lui amenait les cinq rois qu'il avait fait sortir de la caverne, le roi de Jérusalem.
Okay, one of the kings was the king of Jerusalem.
Non, il n'y a pas eu, c'était roi de Jérusalem.
Jerusalem is the house of God.
Parmi les Jérusalem, c'est la maison de l'Éternel.
Jerusalem has a throne that's waiting for Jesus to come.
Jérusalem, il y a un trône qu'attend Jésus pour lui.
And we read here there was a king of Jerusalem.
Et bon, roi de Jérusalem.
That was put in the cave.
Qui était là aussi dans le caverne.
Enemy of God's people.
Et ennemi de mon Dieu.
You know something, Jerusalem is your soul.
Pourquoi Jérusalem c'est dans nous?
You know there are three Jerusalems.
Pourquoi les trois Jérusalem?
Jerusalem the heavenly one.
Qui est Jérusalem céleste?
We came from Jerusalem the heavenly one.
Nous sortis de Jérusalem céleste.
There is Jerusalem in holy land.
Qui est Jérusalem dans la ville sainte?
Where there is a throne. Waiting for a man to sit down.
Et attend pour un homme qui s'assoit.
And this throne exists.
Et trône ça existe vraiment.
You know what is the throne?
Où est-ce qu'il est dedans?
In the Sanhedrin. The Sanhedrin. In Jerusalem.
Et côté trône est réalisé dans un bâtiment dans ville Jérusalem.
In Jerusalem.
In Jerusalem.
There are 70 churches. There are 70 churches. For the rabbis,
pour les prêtres
of the Sanhedrin,
et pour les Sanhedrin,
the Pharisees,
les Pharisiens, ils existent là.
They sit down in the Sanhedrin. The same people that judged Jesus and sent him to death.
Et c'est même nous qui avons jugé Jésus pour aller à la mort.
Using the Romans to kill Jesus.
Était utilisé à la Rome pour détruire Jésus.
Because the authority to kill at the time of Jesus was given to the Romans.
Parce que autorité pour détruire Jésus c'était Romain qui l'a.
And you know the Romans. The son of Esau. And you know Esau? He's the son of the serpent. The same spirit of Cain was in Esau. Esau, you know the brother of Jacob. Yeah. This is the reason why Jacob got the blessing and not his brother. The same spirit of Cain was in
Esau.
He wanted to kill his brother.
Jacob.
You know who else got the same spirit of
Cain?
Remember the king that Israel elected. God did not elect him. King Saul.
Saul.
King Saul got the same spirit of Cain. He wanted to kill his brother. He was a terrible king. David was considered his brother.
When David was considered his brother,
and he wanted to kill him. And he was a terrible assassin. He went and assassinated all the priests from that. He went to the ministry, the holy man of Israel.
When
he
saint.
And Saul killed them all.
Et puis Saül lui-même allait fouiller tout.
This is the Bible.
Look at that.
He got the same spirit of Cain.
Il y a même l'esprit à Caïn.
You know what else Cain did? Witchcraft.
Pourquoi ça Caïn était fait? Vaudou.
When we study the voodoo, all the witchcraft comes from people that come from Cain. Like the seventh generation of Cain to Balkan, you know, he teach the witchcraft.
Generation
of the serpent.
C'est la génération serpentée.
Yeah, you know who got the same spirit of Cain.
On qui est-ce qui a encore même l'esprit à Caïn?
Remember Jethro.
Vous êtes sur Jethro?
Jethro was the witch doctor of Midian.
Oui, dans les diens, Jethro c'est ton docteur satanique qui était.
He also killed people with witchcraft. But you know, there was somebody that had the spirit of Abel. And that name was Moses. The Bible said that when Moses was transformed by God, there was no man on the face of the earth more humble than Moses. So Moses came with the spirit of Abel. And when Jethro, that had the spirit of Cain, recognized Moses, there was a mystery that happened in the spirit. Because the greatest sin of Cain by killing
Abel
was that he stopped the generation from Abel.
When he stopped the generation Abel,
so God allowed the same spirit of Abel to come in Moses.
Bon Dieu te permet l'esprit Abel à te venir Moïse.
And the spirit of Cain got to give the most precious thing that he had to Moses.
Where l'esprit Cain te supposé by ça te plus précieux à Moïse.
And that was Sephora. Because Sephora became a great woman of God. There are many mysteries in the Bible. But let's continue to see what happened to these five kings. The king of Jerusalem.
Mm-hmm.
A different king than Jesus. An evil king. This is the reason why the Sanhedrin got 70 chairs for the rabbis. They got one chair for the coin Agathol. The coin Agathol is like the high priest.
Qui disponible pour Akadolan on prête qui pied de la seconde prêture.
This is 71.
C'est 71.
And they have one chair.
Et une chaise là.
And the chair is empty.
Chaise là vide.
And it has been empty for thousands of years.
Une chaise là vide pour des milliers d'années.
Even from the times of King David. There's a chair there that has been empty.
Même that
chair is the chair of the king. That is the chair that will be only for Mashiach. Nobody sits in that chair. You know who's going to sit in that chair? Jesus Christ. So we're learning some things, perhaps. The church. But the Sanhedrin is still in Jerusalem. The Sanhedrin got the power to tell the government. Even if you are born in Israel, to take all your rights as citizen,
and they
do it today. If you are Jew, you were born in
Israel,
and you become Christian, the Sanhedrin could leave you without any rights as a citizen. This is like a dictatorship. There's millions of Jews that believe in Jesus as the true Messiah. But they don't tell it. They don't want to lose the rights
as a citizen.
This is the work of the generation of the serpent. Remember, the generation of the serpent. The serpent is even inside the Jews. It's a mix. So the king of Jerusalem, the king of Hebron, the king of
Jarmuth,
the king of
Lachish,
and the king of Eglon. Five kings, they were taken out from the cave. Verse 24. And it came to pass, when they brought out those keys unto Joshua,
yes,
that Joshua called for all the men of Israel, and said unto the captains of the men of war which went with him, come near, put your feet upon the necks of these kings.
Mettez vos pieds sur la cou de ces rois.
And they came near and put their feet upon the necks of them.
Ils s'approchèrent, ils misent pieds sur la cou.
I want you to understand something. Jesus told the disciples and the apostles,
when Jesus is disciple,
today I will give you power to put your feet
on the serpents
and on the scorpions. This is the generation of the serpents. Right there in the Bible. Joshua said, put your feet on the neck. Because this is the sons of the serpent. This is what you have to do with the five senses. You put your feet. You be strong. And you let Jesus do the rest. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Verse
25.
And Joshua said unto them, fear not, nor be dismayed. Be strong and of good courage. For thus shall the Lord do to all your enemies against whom you fight.
Car c'est ainsi que l'Éternel traitera tous vos ennemis contre lesquels vous m'en combattrez.
Verse 26, very important. And afterward Joshua smote them and slew them and hung them on five trees as they were hanging up the trees until the evening.
Après cela, Josué le frappa et le fit mourir. Il le pendit à cinq arbres. Ils restèrent perpendus aux arbres jusqu'au soir.
Verse
27.
And it came to pass at the time of the going down of the sun, that Joshua commanded, and they took them down of the trees, and cast them into the cave where the inn had been
hide,
and laid great stones in the cave mouth, which remain until this very day. The principalities that we have inside must be slew with a sword, which is the word of God. parole.
Et épaisse ça, c'est la parole de Dieu.
And you have to understand that you will never be the same person. When you stop those principalities to destroy your life,
lorsque principalités ont détruit la vie,
the five senses are five filters.
Parce que c'est cinq filtres.
And you must get the pure water flowing from your mouth.
Et à flotter dans vos joues.
Hearing the heavenly things. Becoming a sweet smell to the Lord. Touching the throne of God every time you pray. And be the flavor of Jesus everywhere you go.
Go
to
2 Corinthians
2:14.
2 Corinthians 2:14.
Second Corinthians 2,
the verse 14.
We're going to read 14 and 15. He says, now thanks be unto God, which always caused us to triumph in Christ and maketh manifest the Savior of His knowledge by us in every place.
Grâce à Dieu qui nous a fait toujours triompher en Christ et qui répand à nous en tout lieu l'odeur de sa connaissance.
For we are unto God a sweet Savior of Christ in that that are saved, but in them that perish.
Nous sommes en effet pour Dieu le parfum de Christ parmi ceux qui sont sauvés et parmi ceux qui périssent.
Alléluia.
Alléluia.
Now who's tired?
Qu'est-ce qui est fatigué? Everybody.
It's a long message.
So message très long.
But I want to be sure that you could take this and digest it.
Nous avons besoin sûr que nous voyons ça, nous faisons la digestion.
The small things.
The bliss.
I'm going to tell you briefly.
But we're
not going to get deep into story. There was a time when Israel made a covenant. With the Canaanites. And the history of Israel said that he opened in the cities of the Canaanites and killed 7 priests of the Canaanites. The Bible doesn't tell you that they killed 7 priests. But the Bible says that when David was the king, the Canaanites came to King David.
When you vini a David.
King David called
him.
There were 3 years that there was no rain in Israel. So the prophet comes to David.
And said, my
king, this problem that we don't have any rain is because of the Canaanites. God wants you to make justice. Now I want you to understand that Saul is from the generation of the serpent. He got the same spirit of Cain. And so, even though there was a covenant with the Canaanites, Saul killed the 7 priests of the Canaanites. In front of the family.
So when the Canaanites
came to David,
And
you see, David was the king of Jerusalem now.
He was
the king of all cities of Israel. But his palace was in Zion, in Jerusalem. The highest elevation inside the city. You got three elevations. You got Gethsemane, which is the lowest one, which is the Golgotha.
Golgotha.
And the Garden of Gethsemane, that's one elevation. And then you have the Temple Mount, which is Mount Moriah. And then you have another elevation, which is Zion. Zion is the highest one. So they came to Zion, to the king, the Gabonites, and said, "We want to be judged by the law of Moses. A tooth for a tooth and an eye for an eye.
Where on dent pour dent, aux yeux pour yeux.
And a life for a life.
Et on vit pour vie.
And Saul killed seven of our priests. We want seven from the generation of Saul.
Nous besoin aussi sept générations.
So the prophet told David,
c'est ça, prophète, la David,
what God wanted.
C'est ça, pour Jésus,
and David made justice to the Gabonites.
Eh bien, David did my justice avec Abinadab.
He took two sons from one of the daughters of Saul.
He brought deputy, now you the petit fille.
And he took five sons from
Michal,
the oldest daughter of Saul. You know, Michal, he was married to David, but then he divorced and he got another man.
Donc on est, et Michal, Madame David, divorce avec les Polonais.
All of those were generations from the serpent.
Et au tout net, c'était petite génération serpent.
Now, these five sons of Michal and the other two from the other daughter of Saul, there's seven. Those seven were given to the Gabonites and they were handed by the Gabonites.
Where?
Okay, this has to do with the seven serpents. And before I finish, I just want to give you one scripture. Go to the book of Revelation
13.
Okay, Revelation, let's go to Revelation 12. It's also in 13. Let's read one verse because I don't want to get too long. Okay, in Revelation 12, verse 3.
Apocalypse 12, verse 1.
It says, and there appeared another wonder in heaven, and behold, a great red dragon, having seven heads and ten horns, and seven crowns upon his head.
Un autre signe parut encore dans le ciel, et voici, c'était un grand dragon rouge, feu, et ayant sept têtes.
Okay, the dragon is the serpent. In the Revelation 13, you're gonna see that it's a serpent. Revelation 13.
This one.
It says. support and says that the dragon was also called the serpent and Satan and fools everybody.
Satan qui contient tout le monde.
Okay, and that that dragon
is in chapter 12.
Is it chapter 12?
Yeah.
Right here. It's the same thing. I was looking 13, because that 13 also talks about. Yeah, this is chapter 12. Thank you, Pastor. It says in verse 9, he says, "And the great dragon was cast out, that old serpent called the devil and Satan, which deceives the whole world. He cast out into the earth, and his angels were cast out with him." So this
is what
it is. The dragon is the serpent. He has seven heads.
He seven.
Okay, those seven heads got to be related with the seven spirits of evil.
Donc à ouais, cette tête ça a été pour ouais avec cet esprit satanique.
When you accept Jesus, the Spirit of God cleans you, the temple cleans you, ouais, the inside.
L'esprit bon Dieu nettoie en dedans.
But if you don't put a stop to the five keys, which are the five senses,
pour pas mettre un stop de ces cinq ouais.
The spirit that you had before,
l'esprit de garçon,
coming Jesus. And it doesn't have to be that you were born in the body of Christ, you had five generations in the body of Christ. No, because everybody is individual.
Tout le monde est, c'est mon individuel. Pas besoin pour des connaissances d'un corps ou bien combien de fois quatre générations avant.
There are cases that the sons of the ministers are the worst.
Mais quel cas et côté que Jean ministère à you.
Why this happens? Because you don't put a stop to the five keys that are your five senses.
Raison parce que nous pas pété, nous stop, nous pas stopper ces trois
aïeux. So you are the temple of the Holy Ghost and His clean.
Et vous êtes temple du Saint Esprit et propre.
But because you don't put a stop,
à cause de pas mettre un stop,
you start feeding yourselves with iniquity. So the serpent will manifest in you.
The
serpents come from Satan, from the old dragon. This is the old serpent. Only that this serpent got seven manifestations because there are seven fortresses of evil. Amen. Seven manifestations is like seven fortresses of evil, seven principalities of evil.
When Babel, principalities là.
Now, remember I told you that the attributes of God are ten? Okay, those seven principalities got ten attributes.
But this
is the attributes of evil.
Parce que c'est attribut de Babel.
Those ten attributes of evil are going to interact, and the devil will crown you, will give you ten crowns.
When this affair Satan, the devil,
but these 10 crowns are attributes of evil. This happened to me a couple of days ago.
Ça passé quelques jours. assim.
I was praying, I was investigating. And all of a sudden a flash came. And the Lord brought me back to years ago. This was maybe 7-8 years ago. There was a minister's meeting in Jacksonville. And there was there Paul
Dial.
And he started talking about that God creates evil. And there were not so many questions. I remember there were over 400, maybe 500 ministers and leaders from the body
of Christ.
I remember that I got questions because I always got questions. So I had two questions.
I made one question.
And the pastor from North Carolina, Pastor
he's
an old man in the body, he's an elder in the body. White pastor. Well, okay. This pastor started answering me the first question. But then it was like he didn't really quite answer it. I was making the question in order to say something, but I didn't want to disrespect and say this and this. I want them to answer the question. So I remember I had to complete what he was saying. And he said, yes, that's what it is. So it was agreed what I said. And then I had a second question. And then when I said the second question, everybody was like quiet. Pastor Daniel interrupted and said, well, Brother Enrique, we want to give opportunities to somebody else. It's okay, you may sit down. And I just understood because I understand things very quick in the spirit. I did not insist. Because in my question, I was throwing down what he was saying. You could make a question and you could throw down evil
doings.
And the thing is, evil is there to test you. And the one that's testing you is the Lord. Because he wants you to be proven. Like gold. So, if you put a rock over here to block those five kings, do not remove the rock. No matter how bad the situation looks. Remember, the seven spirits of the Lord in the book of Isaiah, chapter 11, verse 1 and verse 2, it is related to the seven serpents of the apocalypse.
Et bien, elle a parlé de cet esprit apocalyptique.
That represent the anti-spirit.
Ça représente l'esprit antiquité.
But we, if we always get subject to the word of God.
Et bien, non. Il est toujours qu'il est arrivé à sujet à manger.
You could cut with a sword, which is the word of God, each one of the heads of the dragon.
Qui c'est la parole de Dieu, chaque tête de la monstre.
We could do that.
Donc appel.
Because there is a process of getting all the seven spirits of God.
Ça c'est un process pour capable capter les sept esprits de Dieu.
The bride of Jesus got the seven spirits of God.
Ouais, l'épouse Christ pour les sept esprits de Dieu.
The bride of Jesus got the ten attributes of the King.
Et l'épouse a supposé qu'elle a dix attributs de Dieu.
In the first message that Peter said. After they received the Holy Ghost.
Après Pierre et Rose devant le Saint-Esprit, premier message dans la salle de Daniel.
There were exactly 17 nations.
Et là, il y a 17 nations.
That changed from darkness to light.
Et il y a 17 nations qui ont changé de ténèbres à lumière.
Seven spirits.
Saint-Esprit.
10 attributes.
10 attributes.
Number 17.
Et il y a 17.
I finish with this.
Finalement.
In Hebrew.
En hébreu.
17 means
et
good,
bon,
something really good.
C'est pour la qualité réellement bon.
And that's what I wish for everybody here.
C'est ça que nous souhaitons pour tout qui là.
To have a good service later on if you have a service.
Si vous avez un service plus tard, pour un bon service.
To have a good understanding of the word of God.
Pour capable une bonne compréhension de la parole de Dieu.
I am more than honored to be here with Pastor Garcin. My health is a lot better since the last time I came. My high blood pressure was 176.
Et sentez mieux que j'en ai dernièrement. Parce que les tensions de 176.
When I came last time.
Now
I am 129.
So on a 129.
So it doesn't matter how hard it is. We keep on studying the word of God. We keep on praying for each other.
Nous continuons à prier pour la gloire.
Et we keep on trusting the Lord.
Et nous continuons à confier pour lui.
I want to ask you finally for the health of my wife Claudita.
Pour nous prier pour Madame Claudita.
You see, this is our situation. I'm going to be honest.
Vous voulez honnête avec nous.
Yes, I
avec l'Assemblée.
I came from New York.
So New York.
A very hard time for me and my wife.